Today we're in Krakow, Poland, and we're here to get to the heart of the food culture in this incredible ancient city.
We wanted to come to Poland in the winter time because the cuisine is so rich, hearty, it's very meat heavy. We've been eating our way all around Krakow to find some really special Polish foods to share with you.
This series is going to be made up of a number of videos covering street food, market food, restaurant food, all the absolute classic Polish dishes you can find here in Krakow.
In this video, we're sharing with you traditional Polish food from Krakow's most beloved local restaurants. We take you to Krakow's first ever fast food joint for the city's favourite street food, into one of Poland's fast disappearing milk bars, former state-run diners, for a hearty traditional meal, and share with you a gigantic Polish pork knuckle from a popular neighbourhood restaurant. You don't want to miss this video. Get ready for some mouth-watering food.
I'm Thomas.
And I'm Sheena, and we're chasing a plate.
We hope you're hungry. Let's eat. We're starting this video in the heart of Krakow Old Town, which is absolutely stunning. This square that we're in is known as one of the oldest medieval squares in Europe. I mean, that building there, which is the old cloth market, that was modernized in 1874. I mean, that's how old stuff is around here. So we're heading for our first food, and actually snow has just started coming down while I'm talking, so I think we've got to get down this little side street and get to our first hot food.
Krakow is the perfect city to explore by foot. It's so charming to wander around. So you've got these cobblestone streets in the old city. You're surrounded by stunning architecture. It's absolutely beautiful. Now, our first stop is actually just up ahead. We're here to eat one of the most popular street foods in Poland. It's called a zapiekanka. It's essentially an open-faced sandwich loaded with toppings. And this place that we're going to is the original shop that invented this street food. So let's pop in and grab one. This is a tiny little hole-in-the-wall shop. It's been open since 1980, and they just sell the one thing, the zapiekanka. They're actually already pre-made, and all she did was she grabbed it and popped it in the oven. It's in the oven right now, toasting up. We ordered the original, so that's the mushrooms and cheese version. I can't wait to try this. It has a really interesting history. Whoa, pyszna. Dziękuję. Whoa, I'm so excited to eat this. Check it out. How good does this zapiekanka look? So it's essentially half a baguette, a very crusty baguette, and then it is loaded with sliced mushrooms, topped with cheese, which is just melted into this gooey mess, and then she drizzled ketchup or tomato sauce over the top. And holy moly, it looks so good. I'm actually going to take a bite from this end right here where there's heaps of mushrooms and melted cheese. That is so good. So pyszna. Dziękuję. Wow, that is delicious. I'm loving the mushrooms and cheese combo. So that is the traditional combination. There's a really long mushroom picking tradition in Poland. They're one of the biggest exporters of mushrooms in Europe. And so mushrooms make up a huge part of the cuisine here. And holy moly. They're sliced super thin and have tons of flavor. That cheese is beautiful. It's just very oozy. It's got a lot of flavor. I think it might be Gouda. And then that tomato sauce. It's just super simple, but perfect. And that bread is so crusty. I'm so stoked that we came to the original zapiekanka shop. So this shop opened in 1980, just as communism was starting to fall in Poland. And it was the first fast food shop in Krakow, because at that time it was against the law to sell American style food. And eating these sandwiches was a way to fight the regime, and it became a symbol of freedom, the zapiekanka. This is fantastic. I'm really enjoying it.
Wow, What a start to this video. That was amazing. And I love that we went to the original shop. So this is the place that invented that sandwich. And it is a sandwich that you'll find all over the city. So it's a very common street food and a very common sandwich, but that is the original shop. And I love how understated it is. So even though we're in the heart of the old town here, which is a very busy part of town, a lot of tourists as well, that is very undercover. There's no pictures, no real signage as to what it is, except that name in Polish on the top. So if you didn't know what that was, you would have no idea what that place was serving. And it is the original place to get that. So a great way to start.
We've left the old town. You can see how the architecture has changed around us. So no more of those medieval buildings. I'm really excited about our next spot. We're taking you to a Bar Mleczny, which is a milk bar. And these are essentially cafeteria style restaurants that serve really simple, hearty, affordable meals. And these used to be state subsidized diners. And at the height of communism, there were about 40,000 of these around Poland. Now there are only about 150. This one that we're going to, which is just up ahead, we've just arrived, is a real local's favorite. I'm getting really excited about tucking into some really hearty food because it's super cold today. Oh my gosh, this place is awesome. It's very nostalgic. So it's got a whole red and white theme going on, tiled floors, plastic tablecloths. It's very quiet in here, but everyone is tucking into some really good looking meals. So we ordered up a ton of food because we're super hungry, really traditional Polish dishes. This milk bar has a great feeling about it. It's very simple, basic. It's self-service, so you go up to the counter, you put in your order, they call out your dish, so you go up to the counter and pick it up. And it's got a great feeling about it. It feels like you've stepped back in time, and it's neat that you can come to Krakow and still experience this tradition. It's packed out with locals, so a ton of people tucking into some really great looking food. We ordered up a real feast, so real classic Polish dishes. This here is the soup, which is kapuzniak, so it's a sauerkraut soup, and you can see how thick it is. It is packed full of vegetables. This here is a dish that is very popular in Poland. It's called kotlet miloni, and it's essentially a minced meat breaded cutlet. Then we've got two scoops of mash and then also some sauerkraut on the side. And this here is a pork schnitzel, and it comes with the same mashed potato and sauerkraut. And we're washing it all down with kompot, which is essentially a stewed fruit water. I'm not sure what flavor this is, but this is gonna go down a treat.
How good does this soup look? It looks super hearty. It's full of potatoes. I can see chunks of carrot, and you've got that bits of cabbage in there, so there's sauerkraut all through that. Oh, that's so good. I got more of the cabbage that time. Oh, that is so hearty. So nice and piping hot. The potatoes just gives it a solid edge, and the sauerkraut, so you've got tanginess of the cabbage in there. Super hearty. It's so nice coming in out of the snow and the cold weather and eating something like that. Wow. We'll get a spoonful with as much sauerkraut as possible. So fermented cabbage, and that's why it's got that real tanginess to the soup. Oh, damn. That is so delicious. It's really well salted as well. So, it's absolutely packed with flavor. I love that soup, and oh man, having a soup in this weather is perfect. And now onto this cutlet, which you can see starts with a huge pile of the sauerkraut. So what's in the soup? So this cabbage, fermented cabbage. It's got a few little bits of carrot in there, and looks like some caraway seeds. So the little dark seeds that are in there. So a big pile of kraut. You've got two big piles of mash with some fennel just cut over the top. So just a little bit of fennel on there, and then this cutlet. Look how golden that looks, all nice and breaded, really golden. Let's cut into this cutlet and check it out inside. Oh, look at that. Now, we weren't sure what meat this was going to be, so that's a pork cutlet. So you can see pork and a few little onions in there as well. Oh, this cutlet looks so good. So we'll get a big chunk. I think the go here is combo, so getting that bit of that cutlet, a whole lot of that potato and the kraut all in one. Again, this is what it's all about with this cold weather. The snow is pouring down at the moment and this hot hearty food. Oh, that cutlet is so juicy. The pork meat, I'm diving in for more because it's very good. It's super juicy. I love how it's crunchy on the outside, the cutlet, and then the meat is very juicy still, hasn't dried out at all. Again, incredibly well seasoned, so it's got a lot of flavor coming out. They've pulled the flavor out of the meat and the onions, a great sweetness from the onions. The potato, mashed potato with this type of meal is a match made in heaven. So they go together like just absolute, like bread and butter, like could not be better. And then the sauerkraut is very, very tangy. So the you've got sort of three distinct things going on: the creamy potato, the nice juicy salty meat, and an incredibly tangy sauerkraut. It goes together so well. And let's have this compote that goes with the meal. Oh, there's a whole lot of berries in the bottom that I've just seen. Oh wow, it looks like it might be maybe blueberries, very hard to tell. Just a nice sweet fruit juice. So very simple and goes really well with the food. Oh, and I'll see what those berries are when I get down there and I can see them properly. It's a bit dark, so I can't see them properly. How is this environment as well? I mean, even this, these plastic flowers on the table, it's red and white tablecloth. Just locals coming in, enjoying this food, and I can see why, because man, the food is absolutely perfect. And this environment is special because it's so rare now. When you've gone from having so many of these 40,000 restaurants down to 150, it's almost extinct, this type of eating. So it's really neat to be able to have this very traditional meal in this environment. I love it.
Let's crack into this schnitzel. So golden crusty crumb on the outside. I believe it's a pork schnitzel. Look at that. Okay, combo it up like Thomas did as well. So tons of that mash and sauerkraut. That's beautiful. The crumb is very crispy and crunchy, very dry, so not oily at all. And the schnitzel, the pork schnitzel, is very thin, pounded super thin. Oh, this is amazing. I really love how it's very affordable as well. So this is pretty much the most affordable restaurant style food you can find in Krakow, and it totally hits the spot.
I've got to the bottom of the compote now, and yes, blueberries. So it's packed with blueberries. So this is essentially just stewed fruit water, I guess is a good way to say it. So it's sugar and fruit, and they stew that fruit to get this drink. But I love how they've kept all those blueberries in there. Oh, packed with flavor too. Oh, those are delicious. That is a very good drink.
So at these milk bars, it's clean up after yourself. So you take your dirty dishes to the clean up window. Chinkuya! That was such a great meal. Oh my gosh, and now the snow has stopped. It's blue sky again. Our tummies are full. We're ready for the next food. It's just gone 5 o'clock. It gets dark really early here in the winter time, but we're setting out for an early dinner because we've heard that this local family restaurant gets filled up really quickly. We're going for a massive meat feast. So a lot of traditional Polish food, but very meat heavy. I can't wait to get into it. We're just coming up to the restaurant here. Their mascot might give you an idea of what we're about to eat. Let's head inside. We just sat down at the last table. We're super lucky to get a spot. And this is such a cute little restaurant. So all wooden tables, there's some really lovely black and white photos on the wall. And we've just ordered a couple of beers. Now this restaurant specializes in galonka, which are pork knuckles. And we ordered a roasted pork knuckle. It's gonna be a behemoth. The owner said it's 1.2 kilos worth. And I can see it actually being popped into the oven right now. It's going to be roasted in a wood-fired oven.
Wow, the oven is amazing. I've just been up there watching the pork knuckle going into the oven. Oh, here it comes. Wow. Oh, look at this. Dziękuję. Wow, this is a giant pork knuckle which I've just watched go in the oven. So he moves it slowly under this huge flame in the very large brick oven, and the crackle on that skin just started popping instantly, and he just spun it around so that crackle is all around it. And look at this thing on the board. So a giant pork knuckle with the cutlery sticking out of it. We've got two huge pickles here, we've got some horseradish, we've got some mustard, and then some nice crusty bread to go with this.
The size of this galonka is unreal. I just want to see how heavy it is. Oh my gosh, this is a weighty beast. So this bad boy is actually cooked in beer first, and then it's finished off in the oven. So you get this really crispy crackle. So can you hear that? It is so crispy. And I actually just want to carve into it to see how tender it is. So let's pick the spot here and just go for the carve. Oh my goodness. Whoa, look at that. The meat just falls apart. So that you've got that crispy crackle on the top, and it just gives way. I barely had to carve it. The meat in there looks absolutely tender. There's this fat on the outside. Whoa. And then you've got, as Thomas mentioned, some really crusty bread. We've got the sauces that are gonna cut through the richness of the meat and those humongous pickles. I'm really keen on getting a taste of this crackle. So what I'm gonna do is just slice a bit of it off without any of that meat and just see how crispy this is. Holy moly, this is so good. You crunch into it and it's very light and crispy, and then it sort of turns a little bit sticky in your teeth. The flavor of that pork is unreal. That is so good. Let's get a bite of this meat. So I want a bit of that fat, a lot of that meat, and just, I'm gonna just go straight in, grab some mustard, or a whole ton of that. All right. That is insane. Wow, that meat is so rich, but it's got a beautiful flavor and it is tender as anything. It just collapsed in my mouth. I got the perfect bite of meat and fat, and it just amazing. It was really great with that mustard too. It sort of cut through the richness of it. These pickles, look at the size of these things. They're massive. Oh yeah, very sour and vinegary. I love a good pickle. This is the perfect accompaniment with this giant beast of a galonka, because you get vinegariness of the pickle, richness of the meat.
I loved watching this galonka getting cooked. I'm gonna grab this bit here because it's got some nice fat on it, some skin, and that crackle. Look at that bubbly crackle. It was very neat watching it in the oven because it was very quickly popping up. So as soon as the flame hit it almost, it just pop, exploded out, and then he'd turn it slightly, pop, it would explode out until he'd done 360 degrees of the pork knuckle and got all of that crackle just exploded all over it. Really neat to watch. And a flavor I love is horseradish. So look how much horseradish there is here. You're gonna take a huge lump of horseradish, dump it on the pork knuckle. I want some nice fatty but nice and juicy. Oh, heaps of horseradish on there. Oh. Oh, this is amazing. Man, that meat is so tender. Oh, so easy to eat, super juicy. And with that horseradish isn't too strong. Sometimes horseradish can be quite overpowering, but that's not. It's mashed very finely, so it's nice and creamy. And it's not completely burning my mouth, even though I had quite a large amount of that horseradish. Now, Sheena has been telling me how good this crackle is, so I need a nice crackly bit of skin. Wow. Oh man, that is a beautiful piece of crackle. It's very light because it's an almost instant crackle. It's not been in the oven for hours and hours, building that crackle up slowly, so you get that very dense, chewy with a real crisp, almost a crack, like cracking a piece of a biscuit, say. That's not like that. It's much softer. It's almost like a pork chip. So it's quite soft, it's nicely aerated, and then the skin underneath still has a little bit of chew going on. So that light crackle with the chew is the perfect combination. Now I want to try a piece with mustard, a thing that I love. I love mustard as an accompaniment, so a whole lot of that too. Wow. Oh, that is incredible too. Oh, it's very vinegary, the mustard, so knocks through the fat in the pork. I think probably the horseradish for me was the winner after just one of each, but man, they were both good. And how perfect is this? So this 1.2 kilogram knuckle served classic on the board with that cutlery shoved in it and this huge mug of beer. Oh, it's a match made in heaven. Oh, cold beer, huge fatty pork knuckle in a very traditional feeling restaurant. So, you know, the wooden panels on the walls and the wooden tables, and everyone's looks so happy coming in here because it's so cold outside. You come in, you've got that big fire going up the back for the oven, so it's very toasty and warm in here. These huge meat dishes being served, so very warming to the body and the soul. Man, this is good.
We're making our way through the Skolanka, and check it out. All the meat has just come clean away from the bone. Look at this. Absolutely meat-free. Wow. I'm gonna make short work of this.